Now, before this video begins, I just want to put out a disclaimer that all revenue made off this video will be donated to this charity. I will go into detail of this charity at the end of the video. Thank you.
Dogs, I want, I, yo, listen, as a matter of fact, let me get it out the way right now. In case I ever do go down due to some dumb shit like Loot Bomber saying, I want to be buried. Where do I want to be buried at the YouTube headquarters in LA. Put me right in front. And I want my tombstone to read "No bitch niggas." That's all. Don't put my name on it. Don't put when I died. No, no bitch niggas buried in front of YouTube headquarters. And I want a silver coffin. And at the fucking funeral, the only song that I want to be played is "Anime Titties." There's a song called "Anime Titties." No, "Anime Pussy." Is that a motherfucking JoJo reference? What's the sound gonna be like here? Yo, this music.
Yeah. She'd look better if she was an anime, bro.
Oh my God! Oh my God! That's all they needed, baby! Case, and I catch them boys slipping, I'ma be like, oh no, where is the money gonna go? None of that. Makes things easy. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna make some more sticks.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Alright, so now.
Did he just nut?
It's a nut! There's a nut button!
And you know what's funny? Like, they give some of the girls, like, these crazy mechanics, and they give the others more subdued mechanics. Mithra's size is present. Movement subdued, but there's a girl in the game called Veil. Everywhere, those things are all over the place. And there's another character too called Perun. She was like the dark skinned beauty. And once again, you can be you jump. They don't just they.
God damn it, man! You know how you're able to fucking masturbate and you know exactly what works.
But you're a guy, man.
That girl looks bad as hell, man. She got the stockings and everything. I mean, I know they're kids.
Ah! Ah!
Oh! 5 is in development.
This is. I don't think. Oh! 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 Here we go! Here we fucking go! Here we fucking go! Oh! What? Oh! Oh! What is this? You're kidding me! Holy sh- God! This is Smash Brothers! What? What are you kidding? Holy shit! Oh! Oh! Oh shit!
Motherfucking fuck!
I got a crush on Chun-Li, cause that bitch is anime. Wanna suck on her teeth.
don't care about no real girls. They can go.
That is not correct. Oh my God. Yo, new Battlefield. New Battlefield, baby. Get about. Yo, Breath of the Wild, love from Pennsylvania. I'm excited, baby. The boys are back. Yo, the fam is back, baby. Yo, where is the bullshit? Oh shit. Oh shit. Pokemon Trainer's back. I got. Stay. Oh my fucking God. Everyone.
But I asked. So, Monado Boy, Sansa.
Whoop. Oh my fucking God. Yo, my dick. Yo, my nuts back. My nuts are preserved, my nigga. Super Smash Brothers Ultimate. The boy is back. Damn it. It's time. Oh, oh my fucking God. Oh my fucking God.
Hey, yo,
hey.
Shared it with the world. He taught myself and many others that it's okay to be honest. You don't have to sugarcoat a damn thing. While I may not have been familiar with all of your content, I want to thank you for sharing your personality with the world and being a voice of encouragement to others in your community. You are one of the realest streamers to ever shine on our platform, and you will not be forgotten.
I'll let you know that I've always loved watching Etika, and his videos always made me laugh. And he will always be appreciated and missed by everyone forever.
I am really, really upset that Etika is gone. When I hear the suicide video, I knew that he was pushed over the edge. And when he started crying on screen, that's what did it for me. When he said everything that he would miss, that really broke my heart. He definitely impacted the whole Smash community, including myself. And he didn't get to see even the last DLC characters, which is kind of upsetting to me because I kind of wanted to see how he would react. Because whenever I see a Smash Brothers character revealed, I always go to Etika and I see his reaction because I love watching his reactions. They were always, always so fun to watch. But I hope that this serves as a lesson. Thank you, Etika. It was really fun having you around.
Etika. The Smash community is just not going to be the same without you, man. We're all going to miss you. And, thanks for all the things that you've done for this community. And just thank you for being awesome in general. I hope you have yourself a dang good one.
You know, Etika to me was my greatest influence. My goal of being a content creator was to get big enough so I could actually meet and maybe become friends with Etika. He was like one of the main reasons why I love the Nintendo community so much, because he would always make things twice as exciting, whether it be Nintendo Direct or Smash Bros or something like that. He'd always just make it twice as exciting as I always was, and I could never be any more grateful or thankful for what he did for us as a community. And he brought us all together. I mean, he always gave out positive vibes. He never purposely sent out negative vibes. It was always positivity when it came to Etika, and that is what really impacted me.
Thank you, Etika. You did a lot of things, and you were a lot of things. All of them good. But most of all, you were an inspiration to me. I remember clearly one time on stream, you responded to people calling you out for overreacting to videos for clout. You dismissed it. It was nothing. That's what I wanted to be able to do. To dismiss all the negatives and only take in the positives. To make people smile. Because that's all you ever did for me, is make me smile.
I'm gonna miss Etika. He got me through a lot. His parent stuff, school stuff. It was horrible. But mostly Etika got me through all this stuff. And like, his optimistic personality really changed me, and I became more optimistic, and now my life's better. And I think it's mostly due to him. And with him gone, it's a bit sad. Oh, not a bit sad. It's very sad, and I really wish I could have done something more, but past is in the past, and I'm still going to be a Joy-Con boy forever.
Thank you, Etika. Thank you for making me laugh when I was sad. When you reacted to all the Nintendo Directs, I felt like I was there with you, laughing. You're a true innovator. You will always be in our hearts. Thank you.
Etika was a really great guy. I miss him. Basically, what I liked about him was, you know, his sense of humor. He was just a generally funny guy, and he seemed really nice, too. I just really miss him. I'm sure a lot of other people do, too. I hope you found peace. Rest in peace, Etika. Joy-Con boys for life.
It's a very big and very heartbreaking event that happened. He was like the heart and soul of the Smash Bros. Community. He was the Smash Brothers YouTuber, and it's kind of hard to believe that what happened actually happened. It is very sad, but I hope that mental like health and like depression and stuff is taken more seriously online now, because that was a huge part of most of the tributes to him, and it is very important. It is very sad what happened, and I don't wish for this to happen to anyone else, but unfortunately it does. Thank you for making this tribute, Pufftendo, and thank you to anyone else who makes videos for him, and I hope that this is a message about mental health in the future for many people on the internet, and yeah, thank you.
Hey Joy-Con boys, my name is Angel. And this is my thank you for Desmond, Etika, and Alpha. I'm not sure if I said that right, but Etika, to me, has been an influence for the past few years, about 2 years now. I haven't known him that long, maybe not as long as some of the other fans, but he's still left a positive impact on me and my life, even to this day, and I just want to say thank you for helping me find the confidence and the strength. But to everyone else watching, you know, just try to remember the things, like the good times, like you said, and through that, they'll never truly be gone. Overall, I just hope that Desmond found the piece he was looking for, and that he can live on through us fans, the real fans. So, thank you, Etika, and thank you to Puff for letting me be a part of this tribute, and Joy-Con boys forever.
I have just found out Etika is dead. When I was younger, Etika helped me. He might have even saved me. I was in a pit of despair, and he helped pull me out. I might not even be here if he wasn't there. And to see the person who helped save me from my depression and my suicidal thoughts succumb to the same thing is almost overwhelming. It is really sad. We will miss you. Thank you.
Thank you, Etika.
Thank you.
Thank you, Etika.
Thank you, Etika.
Thank you for being awesome.
Thank you, Etika.
Thank you, Etika.
Thank you, Desmond.
Thank you, Etika.
Thank you, Etika.
Thank you, Etika.
Thank you for making me a Joy-Con boy.
Thank you.
Parents telling you to do this, do that. Fuck them telling you go to school. Sunshine, fuck them telling you, oh, get this job, do this. It's in your family legacy. No. You do you, okay? Nobody can tell you shit if you make your own legacy. You make your own empire. You make your own standing. No one can tell you shit. And you do it yourself. Make sure you motivate yourself. Make sure the only thing that you need to drive yourself is yourself. And you can get driven with it. These young niggas be asking, man. Strange, always be asking, oh, how'd you get your channel so big? You know what I tell them? I tell them niggas by doing me. You can get your channel big doing anything. You gotta do you. Do you in the chat setup. Do you straight up. That whatever life that you want, you must strive for that shit. You make sure you go for that shit. Don't let anyone tell you it's not possible. Don't let anyone tell you that it's not practical. You make sure that you go for it. You hungry? You want it? Then get it. Get that shit. Don't let nobody stop you. I went to a homeless shelter to get what I have now. I went to a homeless shelter. I struggled. I went hungry 3 nights in a row every week to get what I have. Don't let no one stop you, nigga. No one tell you what the fuck to do. You make sure you get it. Don't let no one stop you, all right? You're driven. You have the energy that you need, the drive you need to get it. You pull that from yourself. Because when you pull it from yourself, no one can influence it. Just you. I'm here, nigga. You know who knows struggles? The people that are dying out there. They know struggle. They're the ones that are suffering. They're the ones that have true hardships. So how can you call your own problems difficult? You rise. You rise. You beat those problems. You don't let nothing stop you, nigga. You take over everything. No, fuck being politically correct, nigga. I'll tell it like I want to tell it. You make sure you do you.
Hello. Thank you so much for those who made it this far in the video. It really means a lot. making this video was really tough for me emotionally. It took a long time, longer than I expected actually. I just want to take this time to thank those who submitted their clips to me for this tribute video. You know, it takes a lot of courage to speak up about things, so a round of applause to you. Now, in the very beginning of the video, I did mention that I'm going to be donating the money I made off the video to a charity. You know, I wish I could take all the revenue from this video and donate it to the charity, but that's sadly not how YouTube works. YouTube's going to take their cut, so whatever cut I get, all of it, 100% of it is going to this charity. The charity is Save Suicide Awareness Voices of Education. It's a suicide awareness program that specializes in suicide awareness, as well as education on suicide and grief support for those who've been affected by suicide and research and stuff like that to help, you know, further understand what the brain goes through leading up to someone's suicide, which could help doctors and psychiatrists figure out what are the key signs that we need to look for to help prevent someone committing suicide. So if you want to find out more about this association, I will leave a link to that in the description. Again, I know I'm not the biggest YouTuber, so I may not be as credible as everyone else, but I am so serious. I cross my heart on my mama, on Etika, on everything, on God, hand on the Bible, Allah. I am not going to take this money for myself. That's evil. I am deleting all this. If you need proof, I will give you all the proof whenever I get this money from this video. So if you want to donate to them yourselves, like I said before, the link to that is in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching it to the very end. I know it was a pretty lengthy video, but I had a lot of things I wanted to put in here for this tribute for Etika. So thank you, Joy-Con boys, again for watching this. My condolences go out to Etika and his family. Rest in peace, Etika, and as always,
please have yourself a damn good one.